Hi kids, welcome to The Joy of Art. I'm your host, Jim Pence, and we're doing a project based on the story of Jonah today. Now, Jonah is one of those stories almost everybody has heard about, even if they don't go to church. God called Jonah to go to the city of Nineveh, and Jonah didn't want to go there. And so he went down to a city called Joppa, hopped on a boat, and went to Tarshish. And if you look on a world map, Tarshish is 180 degrees in the opposite direction. So Jonah was running away from God. But God wasn't going to let Jonah run. And as that ship was out in the water, a storm came up, and the men on the ship didn't know what to do, and they were all praying for some kind of direction. And Jonah finally confessed and admitted to those men, "I'm the reason that this storm has come upon you. You better throw me overboard." And so they did that. They threw Jonah overboard, and we all know the story. This great big whale comes along and swallows Jonah, and he is in that whale for 3 days and three nights. Well, we're going to draw a picture of that whale, and then we're going to color it in with watercolors today, but we're going to add a special twist to that picture, and it's going to be a lot of fun. It's also going to be something that's going to help you remember what the message of Jonah is all about. Most people, when they hear the story of Jonah, they think that whale was God's punishment. And it really wasn't. And as we go through the picture today and work on the project, you'll see what that whale was really supposed to do. So let's find out what we have to have so we can do this project together. And let's sit down and get to work. Now first, you're going to need a pencil. Very simple. Okay, any pencil will do. You're going to need some paper. Now we're working with watercolor today, and watercolor means that you need a good thick piece of paper. If you go to any store that sells art supplies, you can find what's called watercolor paper, and it almost feels like cardboard. It's a little bit heavier than regular paper, but it's great because it's going to soak up a lot of water and enable us to do a really, really neat picture. Okay, so we're going to need our watercolor paper. You're also going to need something to put the water on. We'll put a lot of clear water on at first, and there are two ways to do this. You can get just a craft brush, which is just a little piece of foam on a stick, or you can find a wide brush like this. This is a 2-inch brush, and those are pretty cheap. You don't have to spend a lot of money getting those. We're also going to need another kind of brush, and that's what's called a flat brush. This is a number 14 flat. You can get that in an art supply store. But if you can't find that, these other brushes that you used here at the beginning will work just as well. We're going to need some permanent markers. Even though we're going to use watercolor, we're doing what's called mixed media. So we're using the water paints, but we're also going to use something that isn't going to smear when we put water on it. And so for that, we're using blue. Now you can use black, which is the color that most people have around the house, but blue is going to look a lot better. So if you can find that, great. Black will work, but blue will look a lot prettier. And I've got two kinds here. One is got a fine point, and the other is going to be a little bit more broad, and that's to make it go a little faster. The fine point ones work well, but they take a long time to cover a lot of area. We're going to need watercolors. Okay, this is one set of watercolors. It's got 16 colors in it, and the more colors you have to work with, the better. But we won't really need a whole lot of different colors for this particular drawing, so even if you don't have a 16 color, all we're going to use is a little bit of orange and a little bit of yellow. So if you've got just a regular set of watercolors around the house, that's all you're going to need. Now later on, we're going to need to do some stuff with black light, because that's going to help us put together a special message in this picture that you won't be able to see unless a black light is on. So we're going to need some extreme colors crayons. Now these crayons will glow under a black light. We're not going to use all of them. We're going to use pretty much just the orange and maybe the yellow one, but you need to get a set of those. And then you'll also need a black light, because if you don't have a black light, you won't be able to draw the black light picture, because you won't be able to see what you're drawing. And you also will need it to show your friends this special surprise that's inside that picture. So I'm going to go ahead and put these away for right now, and we'll come back and use those a little bit later. But for starters, we're almost ready. We need a lot of water. Okay, the reason you have a lot of water when you do watercolors is you don't want to mess up your painting with dirty water. So I always have 2 gallons of water. One is going to be clean water. I'm never going to put a dirty brush into it. The other is going to be my dirty water. That's where I'll clean my brushes out. And then we will be ready to go. But before we do the watercolors, we've got to get our picture on the paper. Now I'm going to work with a half a sheet of paper. Most of the time when you buy watercolor paper, it's in a size that is 9 inches by 12 inches, which for the picture that we're going to do with the markers, that's a little bit big. Now you can do it full size if you want to, but sometimes it's easier to work with if you have a smaller piece. So all I'm doing right now is just folding this in half a few times, and that's going to give me a nice crease in the paper. You can also do this with scissors if you want to. But once I've folded it a few times, it's pretty brittle. And then I'm going to just set the paper down. I'm going to come up here to one end and just tear a little bit. And then I'm going to hold with my right hand and just pull. Now I'm doing that because I'm left-handed. If you're right-handed, you're going to do that backwards from the way I do it. But now I've got a half sheet, and that's what we're going to work with. I'm going to put this other sheet away for now. And I'm going to take my pencil and we're going to draw a whale. Now, the whale is easy to draw, but you may want to practice a few times before you actually do the one on your watercolor paper. Sometimes it takes a few tries before you get it right. You know, when artists do pictures, a lot of times they will do what are called studies, which means they will draw whatever it is they want their final painting to be of, and they may draw 5, 6, 7, 8 different versions of it until they're happy with it. And that's so you don't waste a lot of extra supplies and a lot of extra paint getting it the way you want to. So you may want to just take some copy paper and practice drawing a whale for a little while, and then once you're happy with it, then you can come back and do it on your watercolor paper. Now, to draw a whale is really pretty simple. We're not going to try to be exact like I'm drawing a photograph of a whale. This is going to be a very simple whale, and the way to start out doing it, I'm going to press very hard as I draw here. You may want to be a little softer, but so the camera can see it, I want you to watch me draw this whale. It's very simple. I'm going to just start over here, and I'm going to draw almost just like a partial circle. Okay, then I'm going to come down. Once I've come this far around, I'm going to bring that up like that. Okay, all right, then I'm going to draw a curve on that and kind of a swoop. I'm going to draw another little swoop, and I'm going to come back down, and I've almost got a tail. I'm going to draw another curvy line. I'm going to bring it all the way around, just like that. And then I'm going to draw the whale's mouth. I'm going to put a little bit of a curve on it there so the whale looks kind of happy. I'm going to give him an eye right there. All right, so that's all you have to do. Very simple to draw that whale. But again, you may want to practice it a few times so that you get it the way you want to before you do it on your watercolor paper. Now, once you're happy with your whale and you have it on your watercolor paper, you're going to move on to step two. And step two is where we're going to take our fine permanent marker and we're going to go over the outline of the whale, okay? So very simply, gonna go right on there, and I'm just gonna trace right over the outline of the whale. Do this kind of slow, because once this permanent marker is on the paper, it's not going to erase. So you want to take your time with it. Don't be in a big hurry. I'm going to come right around the bottom, and then I'm going to trace up the mouth and come out that way. I'm going to go around the eye, and I'm actually going to color that eye in, and then I'm going to draw several circles out here. These are just a few bubbles, and they don't have to be perfect. Just so everybody knows, the whale's underwater right now. All right, now you may want to pause and go and get this much done, and then we're going to come back in a few minutes and we'll take this to the next step, because we've still got some more work to do with the markers. But go ahead and pause your DVD and trace your whale and draw your bubbles in, and then when you come back, we'll move on to the next step. All right. I hope you've gotten your whale to this point. Now we're going to take it to the next step. Ultimately, we're going to color this whole background in blue, and we're going to leave the whale and the bubbles white. But there's a way to do it so that you don't end up making a mistake in drawing inside your whale. So what you're going to do is we're going to start and begin to work from the outside line of the whale. What I'm going to do is I'm going to widen that. I'm going to start in close. I'm going to move a little bit sideways, and I'm just coming out a little bit like that. I'm not going to try to color the whole picture in right now. But what I'm going to do is move from close into the whale and bring that line out and make it a lot wider. And I'm going to do that all the way around. And the reason I'm going to do it that way, if I start out here and try to draw in, what could happen? Well, I might be going a little too fast and end up drawing inside the whale, and again, I can't erase this. So I want to start always close into the whale and draw out. Okay, with the bubbles, it's a little trickier, but I want to do the same thing. I'm going to follow that same circle of the bubbles. I'm going to start in close, and I'm going to come out. And then with the whale's mouth, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to be very careful. Try to fill that in there. And come out around. All right, you want to do that with the entire whale. You're going to go all the way around, make that line thicker. Be careful not to draw inside the whale. And we're going to make the color around the circles thicker. And once you have done all that, then we'll move on to the next step. So go ahead and pause your DVD, take some time, be real careful, don't rush this, and go all the way around the whale and the bubbles, and then we'll come back. All right, now once we have gone all the way around, we're going to go ahead and fill in the rest of the paper with blue, still leaving the whale and the bubbles white. But it takes a long time to do that with a fine point marker. So now we're going to go to our chisel point, and that's going to make things go just a lot faster. So what we're going to do is stay in the same way that we've been doing. Okay, I'm not going to just go out here and start coloring wildly. I'm going to follow the contour, and I'm going to keep building out from close to the whale, okay, because I want to be sure and stay away from the inside of the whale so I don't end up making a mark that I can't take out. And I'm just going to color all the way out to the edge of the paper. And that's going to take a few minutes. But you want to make sure that you get all of the white spots. A lot of watercolor paper tends to be rough. Like if I don't press real hard, sometimes it's going to leave little white spots and sparkles in there. I want to try to get all those out. So I'm going to color all the way out. Again, we're going to do the same thing around the bubbles. And again, we want to be very careful that we don't color over the bubbles. Come down here and just keep coming out. And so you're going to want to do that now. Okay, if you have a chisel marker, start using that. If you only have the sharp point marker, then go ahead and use it. It'll take a little longer, but it'll still do the same thing. So when you are ready, go ahead and pause your DVD and then color all of the white in, leaving only the whale and the bubbles white. Okay, and when you finish that, we'll move on to the next step. All right, have you got it finished? When you're done, it should look something like this. Should be nice and blue all the way through. Should have gotten pretty much all of your sparkle out. got your bubbles coming up and a nice whale. Now we're ready to take the project to the next step, which is where we're going to use our watercolors. And we're going to, again, only use a couple of colors this time. We don't need a lot of different colors to work with. We're going to use mostly orange and yellow and maybe a little red-orange. Now, you might be thinking right now, I've never seen an orange whale. Well, sometimes we call that artistic license. What we're going to do is make this a certain color so that we can use those black light crayons and hide the picture that we're going to put inside the whale. And so I'm going to be doing this whale kind of in an orangish yellow, and that's going to make it possible for me to draw in something that you really won't be able to see unless a black light is on. Now, another thing that's going to happen is when I use those watercolors, orange and yellow, well, if you know your color mixtures, if you mix yellow and blue, what do you get? You get green. Well, most people think of seawater as kind of a greenish color. So what that watercolor is going to do, it's going to take this blue that we've put on here, and it's going to give it sort of a seawater tint. So it's going to look more like an ocean. So the first thing that we've got to do is we've got to get the paper nice and wet. And then once we have the paper wet with just clear water, then we're going to come back in and we're going to put some color on there that's going to serve two purposes. It's going to make things look nice and seawatery, and it's also going to hide our picture, our invisible picture, for us. I'm going to take the craft brush and I'm going to dip it into my clean water and just get it nice and wet, and then I'm just going to brush all the way over the paper. I want to get the paper pretty soaked. Make sure that it's wet. Sometimes it takes a few times. The water or the paper will soak up a lot of that water. So we want to get it good and wet. Be sure that you're working on a surface that isn't going to get messed up by the markers or by the watercolor. Don't just do it on your mom's best counter. All right, we've got it nice and wet here. All right, now I'm going to go in, I'm going to take my flat brush, still going to go into the clean water, and I'm going to come over here and I'm going to get into my orange paint, and it may take a little bit extra water to get that paint moving. And then once I've got that, I'm going to just start brushing it right on, both over the water and over the whale. Okay, I want it nice and thick and orange. And we'll come back and pull in a little bit of red, orange, and yellow here in a minute. I want to get it all over the whale for starters. And I'm going to color over the bubbles too. All right. And I'm going to clean my brush out real quick. I'm going to tap it out. I'm going to come into the yellow. And add a little bit more yellow. Clean the brush out one more time. Tap it out. I'm going to come into the red orange. I may need a little bit more water there. There we go. We're going to pull some of that red orange in there as well. Again, I'm going to try to cover all the way across the paper. once I have all of the surface of the paper covered, and I have my whale, I'm going to pull my brush across a few times, try to get some of those water bubbles or those air bubbles out of there. And then I need to let my paper dry. And once I do that, I'm going to come back and put a little bit more color on. So pause your DVD, and you can let your paper dry two ways. You can use a hair dryer, or you can just let it sit until it dries out on its own. If you're going to use a hair dryer, be sure and get your mom's permission, and that will speed it up a lot, but you can just let it sit for a little while and it will dry out. But once you've gone through and gotten the color the way you like it, let the paper dry, and then we're going to put a little bit more color on top of it just to make it a little bit more intense. So pause your DVD and have fun with some watercolors. Well, by now your paper should be dry, and once it's dry, you'll see that the color dulls just a little bit, and that's normal with watercolors. So if you want to make the colors brighter and more vibrant, you're going to need to put a second coat on. And if you do that, then it's going to look more like this. Now, to get that second coat, you don't want to wet the whole paper this time. We want the paper to be dry, but then you're going to go back and do just like you did before, get into the red, orange, and the orange, and the yellow, and just go over the whole paper, and then let it dry another time. Another reason that for this particular project that's important is we're going to be using an orange blacklight chalk, and the orange in the whale is going to hide the picture that we draw under the black light. So if you want to, you're going to take a few minutes and put another coat on there, and whenever you're ready and the paper is dry again, you need the paper to be completely dry before you use the black light crayons. Once your paper is dry, then it's time to do what I call the most important and the most exciting part, and that's the invisible picture. So let's take our picture over and put it up so that we can see what we're doing under a black light. Now, for this part of the project, we need some special supplies. These are called extreme color crayons. They're crayons, but they glow under a black light. You can buy them at craft stores, art supply stores, or even from our website, seethelightshine.com. And you'll also need a black light if you want to see this picture really come to life. And you can, again, get that from us at seethelightshine.com, or, again, just about any craft store or store that sells bulbs and electrical supplies will have black lights. So let's get started on the black light project. All right, kids. This is the most fun part of the picture for me. We're going to use only two of the extreme color crayons. We're going to use Lemon Glacier and Sizzling Sunset. We're going to start with the Lemon Glacier and just go over the outline of our whale. So if you're doing this, you don't actually have to draw this part with a black light on. It's maybe a little bit more fun to do it that way. Just go right around the outline, and that way we can see the whale in the black light. Okay, you need to press down hard as you do this. Come all the way around, and that way you can see the whale. If you want to go into where his eye is and go around the circle of his eye, that way you can see that part too. You may have to go over the fish or the whale a couple of times to get a good strong outline. But that part's okay. I want to get a nice strong picture. Do the same thing with the bubbles. Let's go around each one of them, pressing hard. And that's pretty much all you need to do right now with the Lemon Glacier. So go ahead and get your Sizzling Sunset. And this is where we're going to draw the part inside the whale. Now, what would you expect that we would normally draw? Well, most people would say, well, you probably draw a stick figure of Jonah. Well, whenever I do blacklight pictures, especially when I'm working in chalk rather than crayon. But when I do big pictures with black light in them, I always like to surprise people and put up something that they didn't expect. Well, a picture like this, everybody would expect Jonah, but I'm going to put something different in there. I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to draw, first of all, just a little line here that is going to look kind of like a rocky hill. And then I'm going to draw a cross right here in the middle. Now, why would I draw a cross inside the whale? In fact, I'm going to put three crosses because when Jesus was crucified, there were three crosses on that hill. And people say, well, what does that have to do with the story of Jonah? Well, very simply, when people think of the story of Jonah, they think of the whale as a punishment that God sent to Jonah for running away. And that's not true. The whale was not a punishment. The whale was what saved Jonah. Because if they had thrown Jonah out of that boat and there had been no whale there to take him, what would have happened to Jonah? He'd have drowned. But because God provided that whale to swallow Jonah, Jonah lived. Now I'm going to go back to my other color, my lemon glacier, and I'm going to draw in just some lines that could be little weeds, seaweed, whatever you want. I'm going to put them around the whale. You know, in the second chapter of the book of Jonah, Jonah prays a prayer, and the last verse of that prayer is salvation comes from the Lord. And that's what Jonah was thankful for. He was thankful that God sent him that whale, because if he hadn't, Jonah would have died out there in the sea. And so that whale is a reminder to you and me that God sent us a Savior as well. But our Savior wasn't a whale. Our Savior is Jesus, who died on that cross and rose the third day. So as you think of the story of Jonah and the whale, remember Jesus, our Savior, who died for us, who became for us salvation. Remember what Jonah said at the end of his prayer, salvation is of the Lord. And he's the one that will save you and me through his son Jesus. Thanks for being with me on The Joy of Art today. I hope you've had fun with this project. It's one that you can share with all your friends, and a special way that you can tell them about the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm Jim Pence, and I'll be looking forward to being with you again on The Joy of Art.